In the previous movie, we set up a unit flow graph to trigger servo's animation states and to control its rotation using a game controller. In this movie, we'll add a movement flow graph that accounts for collision detection. Open the level Servo Basic Movement from your current project. You can also use the files provided with this movie by merging them into a new Stingray project. Open Servo's unit flow graph in the unit editor. To translate Servo's unit in our level at runtime, we'll use a Move Unit node. This node requires either a delta position or a velocity. For this tutorial, we'll use the delta position port, which calculates a position difference based on the time elapsed between frames, or delta time. Since we already calculated Servo's facing direction in the previous movie, we can retrieve it and apply a magnitude or a speed to it, which will give us a movement vector. Create a Get Unit World Rotation node and connect it to a Vectors from Rotation node. This gives us a vector based on Servo's rotation. Let's connect it directly to the Move Unit node and see the results. Save your unit flow graph and test the level. Without a speed modifier, Servo runs across the level at breakneck speed based solely on the position vector extracted from its rotation. This vector has a magnitude ranging from -1 to 1 on the x and y axes, which is far too high for Servo's animation. We therefore need to reduce it by multiplying the vector. Use a vector times numeric node. Set the numeric port to 0.1. Save your unit flow graph and test your level. Servo now runs at a more controlled pace. However, instead of setting an arbitrary value, we can extract the speed from the run animation's root motion. Create a Get Unit Animation Controller Root Motion node. Connect it to the Level Update node. Connect the node's delta position port to a vector length node, and connect its numeric output to the vector times numeric node. Save your unit flow graph and test your level. Servo's speed is now based on the animator's work. You've probably noticed that Servo's clipping through the environment. This is due to the lack of collision detection. To address this, go to the Unit Editor's Viewport tab. Then, go to Create Mover. The mover is represented as a capsule volume and prevents Servo from colliding with nearby physics volumes. In the Properties tab, adjust height to 1.5 meters, then save your changes. Next, we need to convert the wall units into rigid bodies. Open the Platform Wall Unit. In the outliner, select Wall Geo and go to Create Physics Actor. Rename the new physics volume to Collision. Then, set the type to Box to change the volume's shape. Save your changes. Go back to Servo's Unit Flow tab. We need to add Servo's new mover to his movement flow graph in order to properly detect collisions. Instead of moving Servo directly, we'll pass its delta position result to its mover using a Move Mover node. This mover acts as a collision scout for the Servo unit. To return the mover's position, create a Get Mover Position node. Since the Move Mover node already calculated the delta position, we'll replace the Move Unit node with a Set Unit Local Position node, which receives absolute values. Save your unit flow graph and test your level. Servo now collides with the game environment. Let's tidy up our flow graph so it's easier to read. Select the nodes controlling servo's animation events. Press the Ctrl G key to bundle them together. Next, group the nodes that control servo's rotation as Rotate Unit. Finally, group the last set of nodes as Move Unit. Save and close your unit flow graph. As we mentioned in the previous movie, this flow graph is saved as a flow file in your project folder. Open this file in a text editor. This file's data structure is formatted using simplified JSON to make the data easier to read and edit. Locate the last group you created and rename it Move Unit using Mover. Save the file and reopen Servo's unit flow. Stingray updates the unit flow graph accordingly. You can also build more complex flow graphs using a modular approach. In the files provided with this movie, we included a keyboard controls text file containing keyboard input mappings. Copy-paste it from the text editor to Servo's unit flow. To use it in your graph, reconnect the thumbstick node to the vector addition node, and then reconnect the existing flow graphs accordingly. Save your unit flow graph and test your level. You can now control Servo using both a game controller and arrow keys. Using the techniques learned in this series, you can iterate on this flow graph and implement your own movement controls.